In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all,
and with your spirit.
Good morning and welcome. We're going to speak about how the importance of people. It's people and not possessions that is our real treasure. And as we prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us take a moment to acknowledge our sins. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You were seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you. We adore you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, and the glory of God the Father. Let us pray. O God, protector of those who hope in you, without whom nothing has firm foundation, nothing is holy, bestow in abundance your mercy upon us, and grant that with you as our ruler and guide, we may use the good things that pass in such a way as to hold fast even now to those that ever endure. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the first book of Kings. The Lord appeared to Solomon in a dream at night. God said, "Ask something of me, and I will give it to you." Solomon answered, "O Lord, my God, you have made me, your servant, king to succeed my father David. But I am a mere youth, not knowing at all how to act. I serve you in the midst of the people whom you have chosen, a people so vast that it cannot be numbered or counted. Give your servant, therefore, an understanding heart to judge your people and to distinguish right from wrong. For who is able to govern this vast people of yours?" The Lord was pleased that Solomon made this request. So God said to him, "Because you have asked for this, not for a long life for yourself, not for riches, not for the life of your enemies, but for understanding, so that you may know what is right. I do as you requested. I give you a heart so wise and understanding that there has never been anyone like you up to now. And after you, there will come no one to equal you. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, we know that all things work for good for those who love God, who are called according to his purpose. For those he foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his Son, so that he might be the firstborn among many brothers and sisters. And those he predestined, he also called. Those he called, he also justified. And those he justified, he also glorified. The word of the Lord.
Blessed are you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for you have revealed to little ones the mysteries of the kingdom.
Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said to his disciples, "The kingdom of heaven is like a treasure buried in a field, which a person finds and hides again. And out of joy he goes and sells all that he has and buys that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant searching for fine pearls. When he finds a pearl of great price, he goes and sells all he has and buys it." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise
to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Well, again, a special welcome to all who may be visiting. It's all about people. It's all about people. Mother Teresa once said, "How can you say there's too many children? That's like saying there are too many flowers. There'll never be enough people." And where is our treasure? We're going to speak about that. We're going to speak about these two examples of finding treasure. One, you know, the person who finds the treasure in a field, and then the merchant searching for a fine pearl. Jesus is the kingdom of heaven. And he said, "Where two or three are gathered in my name, there I am in your midst." You know, they did a study a few years, well, a book just came out this past year called The Good Life. And it's all about the research of this Harvard study. It's the longest study into human happiness. And they're trying to determine what is it that makes people happy? And it wasn't possessions, it wasn't riches, it was people. It was people. And specifically, the quality of our relationships. Now, this was written from a secular perspective. Let me see if I can find a wonderful quote, you know, how they describe the good life. The book is The Good Life, Lessons from the World's Longest Scientific Study of Happiness by Robert Waldinger. Spoiler alert, the good life is a complicated life for everybody. The good life is joyful and challenging, full of love but also pain. And it never strictly happens. Instead, the good life unfolds through time. It is a process. It includes turmoil, calm, lightness, burdens, struggles, achievements, setbacks, leaps forward, and terrible falls. And of course, the good life always ends in death. A cheery sales pitch, we know. But let's not mince words. Life, even when it's good, is not easy. There's simply no way to make the life perfect. And if there were, then it wouldn't be good. Why? Because a rich life, a good life, is forged from precisely the things that make it hard. Interesting. Now, this is written from a completely, purely scientific, secular perspective. And what does Jesus say? He says, take up your cross and follow me. He doesn't promise the easy life either, but he promises happiness in this life and in the life to come. And what does that happiness consist in? Loving people and not things. Loving people and not things. Last night, Father Joe and I got to experience, I think it was a little taste of heaven. Maybe I'm overstating the experience, but went to Luigi's in Old Saybrook. They're open again. This Mass is not sponsored by them. I'm not, But if you know their story, they were closed. It's a wonderful restaurant. It's a family restaurant. They were closed from right after Christmas, and this was their opening weekend. And it was packed. And there were people everywhere. And people were smiling. And I got to see some old friends, and we all got to see some other people. It was great food. Jesus likens, the scripture affirms that the heaven is the wedding feast of the Lamb. And hopefully we get a taste of that at every Mass. Well, last night was a taste of heaven. And what made it special? What made it special was the people. Let me see if I can get this right. Matthew Kelly once had, what did he say? He said, we're supposed to use things and love people, but we turned it the other way around. Instead, we love things and use people. It's all about people. And that's what all that, you know, it took them 84 years to do all this research into the lives of all these people, and it's the most significant study of its kind to date. And that was their conclusion. What does that mean for us? It means it's never too late to develop quality relationships. And we're created in the image and likeness of God. God is a trinity of persons. One God, three persons, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And that's why it's the importance for us to build community. Vatican II spoke about the four presences of Jesus at the Mass. He spoke about the presence of Jesus in the assembly. That's where everyone's gathered right now. The presence of Jesus in the word that we just heard. The presence of Jesus in the church's minister. And the presence of Jesus in the body, blood, soul, and divinity of the Blessed Sacrament, the Eucharist. I remember quite vividly, just 3 years ago, how sad and lonely it was celebrating Christmas Mass here in this church. And it was empty, if you remember, because of COVID. It was sad. It was really sad. The one of the great feasts of the year that should be, the church should be full of people, was empty. What's the great treasure of Christ the King Church? It's not the finances. It's not this beautiful building. It's the people that make it so special. And that's what Jesus is communicating today. In just over a week, we're going to be celebrating the feast of St. Lawrence the Deacon. He had been a deacon for one of the popes who had been martyred. And then they came after him and they said, bring us the treasures of the church. Well, they expected that he would bring gold and silver and other precious objects. What did he bring? He brought the sick, the elderly, the lame, the poor, the disabled. And they were furious. But that's where true treasure lies. You know, Father Joe and I both know as priests, when you're at the bedside of a dying person, they don't ask, oh, bring me my boat, or bring me my my car or my house. No, they want to be surrounded by those whom they love. They wanted to be surrounded by their loved ones. The richest person in the world is the person that knows Jesus Christ. The richest person in the world is the one who cultivates relationships based on Jesus Christ. Let me find another quote from that book. The author states, all of these studies, and there's many, many studies on happiness and well-being, as well as our own Harvard study, bear witness to the importance of human connections. They show that people who are more connected to family, to friends, and to community are happier and physically healthier than those who are less well-connected. People who are more isolated than they want to be find their health declining sooner than people who feel connected to others. Lonely people also live shorter lives. Sadly, this sense of disconnection from others is growing across the world. About 1 in 4 Americans report feeling lonely, more than 60 million people. I spoke about that a few weeks ago, how the Surgeon General is speaking about how loneliness is a new epidemic. What am I stressing? Love the people you're surrounded with today. That way, you won't be surprised, because guess what? Heaven is full of people. It's people. So if you're running away from people now, be careful. We're to love them. We're to love them. And I know it's not always easy. I'm an introvert. I don't like crowds. And look what God has done. He's taken, you know, my raw personality, and he's using the gifts and talents to build his kingdom. And he does the same thing with you. You know, it's all about people. It's all about relationships. And the good news is Jesus is in the business of healing relationships. Every Mass is a healing Mass. Jesus is in the business of bringing physical, mental well-being into our lives. Treasure people. Treasure people. They are the greatest gift that you and I will ever have. Amen. Please stand. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. God our Father calls us to the knowledge of truth and wills all people to be saved. Let us pray to him with all our hearts.
That our Holy Father, all bishops, priests, deacons, and religious will be enriched by the gifts of the Holy Spirit, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Lord Jesus may be with his church and guide it always, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That world leaders will have the wisdom to see that the greatest treasure is human life itself, and may work to protect and enhance that gift. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we learn to put our trust in God in everything we do. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Lord Jesus may rescue those deprived of freedom and liberty and give them courage and strength. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the poor and oppressed, for the sick and those who care for them, for those who feel isolated and lonely, and for all our friends and loved ones who need our prayers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have gone before us in faith reach their reward in heaven. For David Hickey, Mrs. Patricia Ann DeMarco, mother of Reverend Anthony DeMarco, and especially for James Borland, for whom this 10:30 a.m. Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for all those who are suffering from heat and storms this summer, that they may find comfort in the Lord and in a caring community. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, hear the prayers of your church and grant us the gifts and graces which we ask for with faith. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. The Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our good, good of all his holy church. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings which we bring from the abundance of your gifts, that through the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries may sanctify our present way of life and lead us to eternal gladness through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." every faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring it to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Michael, our Bishop, with the clergy, the religious, and all your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us share with one another a sign of Christ's peace.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed.
that came into
those watching at home will make an act of spiritual communion. By Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. St. Michael prayer. St. Michael, the archangel, in this battle, be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. Do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who are all about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Just a few announcements. The Vacation Bible School is coming up. That's August 7th through the 11th, and there's still spaces available. We also have the elections for our parish council. You'll see the picture and a little bio of each of the people that were nominated. You know, so please stop by, please vote. And on August 12th, Saturday, we're having a steak dinner sponsored by the Men's Club. It's for everyone, it's for families, community. Great way to build community and have a wonderful meal. So those are all in the narthex. Let us pray. We have consumed, O Lord, this divine sacrament, the perpetual memorial of the passion of your Son. Grant, we pray, that this gift, which he himself gave us with love beyond all telling, may profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.